Melania Trump kicked off her solo three-city Be Best tour on Monday morning with a very stylish stride across the tarmac at Andrews Air Force Base, her first public appearance in 2 weeks. The 48-year-old First Lady certainly made an impression as she stepped out in front of the cameras, modeling a funky yellow and purple ensemble that was finished off with a pair of unique $695 yellow plaid heels from one of her favorite footwear labels, Manolo Blahnik. Despite the chilly March weather in Washington, D.C., Melania chose to go bare-legged, but wrapped up in a yellow turtleneck sweater, which she wore under a long belted $6,680 purple coat from Bottega Veneta. A matching purple skirt worn under the coat completed her look. The vibrant turtleneck is clearly a firm favorite in Melania's closet. She wore the same style in February last year, when she and her husband were pictured leaving the White House in order to make a trip to Ohio together. Melania seemed to be in good spirits as she made her way out of her SUV and onto the waiting military plane, which was bound for Oklahoma, the first stop on her two-day, three-city Be Best tour, during which she will discuss the key aspects of the initiative, the well-being of children, online safety, and opioid abuse. From Oklahoma, the First Lady, who is traveling without her husband, President Donald Trump, will travel to Washington State, and then Nevada before returning home. The mother of one smiled and waved for the photographers as she made her way across the tarmac, wearing her brunette hair in loose, natural-looking waves around her shoulders, while also showing off a large diamond ring on her right hand as she held it up to greet the cameras. Melania was also seen wearing her wedding rings on her left hand, however it is unclear whether she chose to model the original $1.5 million, 15-carat diamond her husband proposed with, or the impressive $3 million, 25-carat rock he gave her to celebrate their 10th anniversary. Monday marks the first public appearance that Melania has made in 2 weeks. She appeared a week ago Sunday at the annual Governor's Ball at the White House, but her last public event was unveiling a healing garden at a children's hospital in Miami on President's Day. Melania also introduced her husband before he delivered remarks on the humanitarian and political crisis in Venezuela that day in Miami. Whether it is social media and technology or drug and alcohol abuse, children in our country and around the world are faced with many challenges, the First Lady said about her Be Best tour in a statement. Through Be Best, I will continue to shine a spotlight on the well-being programs that provide children the tools and skills required for emotional, social, and physical well-being and promote successful organizations, programs, and people who are helping children overcome some of the issues they face while growing up in the modern world. In Tulsa on Monday, the First Lady will visit an elementary school that focuses on incorporating character education throughout its curriculum. She will then visit a tech company near Seattle to learn about their programs and applications to teach children online safety. On Tuesday, she will participate in a town hall on opioids in Las Vegas. The First Lady has already promoted her Be Best campaign in the Washington, D.C. area, and has also helped to spread the word about the initiative during day trips, including an October visit to a children's hospital in Philadelphia. She has also made day trips to the U.S. Mexico border to visit migrant children separated from their parents under her husband's immigration policy. Last year, Melania made her first solo overnight trip since becoming First Lady, traveling to Africa for a four-night visit, during which time she visited schools and hospitals, as well as several wildlife conversations. But although she seemed delighted to be out and about, Melania still steered clear of answering questions from reporters, including one that was shouted out about her husband's former attorney Michael Cohen. As Melania was boarding the plane, a reporter tried to ask her if she accepted the apology made by Cohen, who told Congress last week that he had lied to the First Lady about Donald Trump's alleged affair with pornographic actress Stormy Daniels. It is not clear whether Melania heard the question over the noise of the plane engines on the tarmac. Cohen paid Daniels $130,000 in the closing months of the 2016 campaign for her silence, later claiming in open court as he pleaded guilty to a raft of federal crimes that then-candidate Trump ordered him to do it. "He asked me to pay off an adult film star with whom he had an affair and to lie to his wife about it, which I did," Cohen said of the president on Wednesday during a House Oversight and Reform Committee hearing. "Lying to the First Lady is one of my biggest regrets. She is a kind, good person. I respect her greatly and she did not deserve that," he added. Daniels claimed she and Trump met in July 2006 at a celebrity golf tournament and had sex. "It was the start of an illicit affair," the porn star claims. At the time, Trump had been married to Melania for just over a year and their son, Barron, was 3 months old. The president denies ever sleeping with Daniels.